Hi, Rosie.
Hi.
Hi, Stance.
Hello, Stan.
Hi, Ellie.
Hi, Ellie.
You're on mute. You'll have to unmute yourself.
It's on the bottom left-hand corner.
Unmute.
Hi. Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm sorry, Stan. I'm not that good with all this technology. What have you called us all here for?
Well, it's getting near to Easter, so I thought I'd gather you all together to tell you a story.
Sounds good to me.
Yay! I'm in.
My grandma and mum passed these stories down to me, and now I have my own story to add. So if you're sitting comfortably, then I'll begin.
We've a story to tell to the people. From a baby boy it was told. A story that starts with a journey. A journey to Bethlehem.
Our story starts 2,000 years ago in a little town called Nazareth. My grandma, Jenny, was busy munching grass, minding her own business, when her owner, Joseph, gave her an important job to do.
Well, Jenny, we've got a long journey to go on. We have to go to Bethlehem to be counted. I need you to carry all our belongings. I can't let Mary carry anything. She's going to have a very special baby.
Jenny was over the moon to be chosen for such a task. None of the other donkeys were strong enough to carry the luggage that far. The family travelled for miles and miles, and when they got to Bethlehem, there was nowhere left for them to stay, so they had to sleep with the animals. Now, you might think that's a dreadful thing, but Jenny was dead chuffed. And that night, it was extra special, because Jenny was there when Mary's baby was born. I expect you already know most of this story. There were angels and shepherds and so many other visitors. It got quite crowded. I wonder if you can tell me the baby's name. Jenny thought they'd name the baby after Joseph. But it turns out they named him. Yes, you're right. It was Jesus.
Jesus means God saves. We'll learn more about this later in Stanley's story.
Grandma Jenny is now a very old and retired donkey, but she has never forgotten the joy she felt that night. She made sure she told everyone who would listen, and a few who wouldn't. A few years later, Jenny became a mum herself, to Annie. Annie grew up playing with the child Jesus, and... But wait, that's Annie's story to tell.
We've a story to tell to the people of the boy whose killing was done. Continuing this boy's journey, a journey to Jerusalem.
Hi all, I'm Annie, Jenny's daughter and Stanley's mum. Let me tell you all about the boy Jesus. We grew up together in Nazareth, I watched that boy grow and try out new things. You should have seen him trying to help his dad, Joseph, in the carpenter shop. Oh my, what a lot of cuts and bruises. People began to wonder if he'd ever follow in Joseph's footsteps and take over the family business. When Jesus was 12, it was time for him to start thinking about his future. Mary and Joseph took him to Jerusalem, to the temple, to celebrate Passover. It was a big party. And guess who they took to carry their luggage? Yes, it was me. My mum had grown too old for such a long journey. We spent a week in Jerusalem, then headed back home to Nazareth with most of our friends from the town. That night, Mary looked for Jesus to give him his supper, but he was nowhere to be found.
Jesus, Jesus, where are you? Have you seen a young boy about this high?
No, sorry.
Have you seen Jesus anywhere?
No, sorry.
Have you seen Jesus anywhere?
No, sorry.
Mary asked everyone, but no one had seen him. So Mary and Joseph went back to Jerusalem. Talk about making a long journey even longer for a poor, tired donkey. Well, when we got back to the temple, what a surprise! Jesus was talking to the leaders and teachers. Imagine that!
Jesus, what are you still doing here?
He's been asking and answering lots of questions. This boy knows a lot about God.
Mother, did you not know I would be in my father's house?
Mary and Joseph didn't really understand what Jesus meant. But by saying he was in his father's house, Jesus was saying that God was his father. That was a bold statement to make, and he proved himself to my son Stanley.
We have a story to tell to the people of a man who came to free. A story that ends with a journey to Calvary. A journey to Calvary, and the donkeys will tell. Story. It's the story of God's great might. For God's Son Jesus has come to earth to give us his love and light.
20 years later, Jesus needed to ride into Jerusalem again. But this time he needed to ride on a young donkey, and I was the one chosen for the task. It was amazing. People shouted and cheered, and they lay palm branches and coats for me to walk over. Jesus was a superstar celebrity, and I was carrying him. Everyone loved him, but oh, how that all changed. Within a week, the crowd had turned against him and wanted him killed. Jesus was killed on a cross at Calvary, and it looked like that was the end of the story. But the most amazing part of the story is still to come. When his friends went to his grave 3 days later, he was gone. And while they were still wondering and trying to work out what had happened, who should appear to them but Jesus? He was alive!
Three donkeys. Three stories. Each donkey got to witness to a special part of Jesus' life. Jenny saw him born, and he saw him start his adult life and tell the world that he is God's son. And Stanley got to witness Jesus rise from the dead. When Jesus rose again, he paid the price for all the wrong things that we do, the things Christians call sin. It says in John chapter 3, verse 16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. All you need to do is put your trust in Jesus, God's Son, and ask him to save you.